Hey, this is Max here, and in this tutorial I want to show you how to use tags inside ActiveCampaign. So first I want to explain you what they are, then how you can actually use them, and then some quick tips about how to name them, and then I also want to show you some automations about how I use tags inside those. So let's dive right in. So let's first talk a bit about what tags are, and I can actually keep that really short because it's really, really simple. So tags are like little labels that you can add to your contacts. And usually you do that to store some kind of information, like an action they did, maybe a page they visited it, like a preference they have, something that they're subscribed to, something that they purchased, something that they wanted a refund for, like all kinds of different things. So when you go over to ActiveCampaign and when you go to your contact, it will look like this. So under the general details, you'll see tags, and you see that this person right now has 4 different tags. So yeah, that's basically already what they are. So it's just like to store like little pieces of data, but I'll give you more examples in a bit. So what do you use them for? Now, the possibilities are really endless, I think, but I think these are the 3 main things that you'll probably use them for. So you'll probably use them for to trigger an automation when a tag is added or removed. So that's really handy. We'll show you an automation about that in a bit. How you can split automations based on which tags a subscriber have. So if they do have a certain one, or maybe they do not have a certain tag, then you can go different paths inside an automation. And then the last one, and I think this is incredibly cool, is that you can personalize your emails based on the tags a subscriber has. So you can use conditional content to show like a certain paragraph of text inside an email to a person who has a certain tag. And I think that's incredibly cool to personalize your emails. So I'll also show you how that works in a bit. But first I want to talk a bit about how you should name your tags, because I know a lot of people struggle with that. I see this question again and again and again. So this is how I name my tags. I do not say that this is the best way. There's lots of different ways, but this is just something that I really, really like. So I like to categorize my tags. So I have like a main category for the tag, a subcategory, and then a specific thing. So I created a cool Google Sheet. I called it the email tagging framework with like a bunch of examples. I will show you that right now, but before I do that, I just want to let you know that there's also a link in the description below so that you can just import the tagging framework and change to your own needs. So this is the tagging framework, and as you see here, I categorized all of them, and then we have the examples, and then I gave the short description about when to add a certain tag or when to delete it. And yeah, what I really recommend you to do is to import this and then to change it to your own needs. So maybe you have different categories in your business that you need, then you can just add a few new ones, or maybe you, for example, do not have a membership site, and then you can just replace this by another one. And what this does is that it gives you like a clear framework while you create your automations. Then when you need a new tag, you just dive into this Google Sheet and you just look up how you called previous similar tags. So I would really recommend you to do that, especially in the beginning. After a while, you will exactly know which ones you already have and which ones not. But in the beginning, this is like a really good practice. So let me explain a couple of them. So here we, for example, have our tags that are related to sales. So you see here that we have our main category, which is sales, then our subcategory, in this case, that's purchased. And then here there would be a product name. So for example, when you go over to John Doe here, you see the John Doe sales purchased funnels that convert. So it's really easy to see what this person actually bought. Now, if then the person would get a refund for that same product, they would get the tag sales refunded funnels that convert. Or maybe they checked out, or not checked out, but they looked at the checkout page and then they did not buy. And then we give them the abandonment tag. Now, or maybe if a recurring payment fails, then you can also add a tag for that. So yeah, these are all my sales tags that are like relevant to me. Maybe there's still a couple of missing for you, but I think for most of the people, this will do. And then you see here that I also explained when you add or remove them. So for example, when someone gets a refund tag, you should remove the purchase tag so that you can just keep like your subscribers' profiles clean. Now, then we also have interest tags. So I think it's really important to like track what people are interested in so that if you in the future, for example, here have a product about email marketing, that I only bother people with that that are actually interested in that topic. Now, then we have events, and these are probably the tags that you'll use most often. So for example, when someone is requesting like a certain freebie, then you can give them a tag that says event requested, and then here in this example, checklist. And then actually when they received it, you can remove the requested tag and then add the received tag. I'll also show you in a bit how that works inside an automation. And then we have like a bunch of different tags. So either pause the video and look at it or import the example and then look at it. But yeah, I think it's really, really important that you give them like clear names, because otherwise things are getting, just becoming like a huge mess, and you will have like maybe different tags for like the same thing because you didn't know it existed already, etc., etc. So really, really important. Now, then I want to show you some examples of how to use tags inside your automation. So I want to show you how you add a tag when a form is submitted, how you can start an automation when a tag is added, and how you can split an automation based on a tag. And then I did not write it here, but I also want to show you the conditional content. So let's start with the form. So let's go over to forms, and then I clicked here the wrong thing. So we go to forms, and then you see here that I have a form that is called Get Cheat Sheet. Now, it's a very simple form that I just put on my website. When they filled it out, they get a cheat sheet. So what I want to do is I want to give everyone who like fills out this form a tag. So to do that, you go to options, and then under options, you see form actions. So now the thing that you should do, you should subscribe them to your list, and then we add a tag. Now you see that I already did it here, but I'll just do it again. So you click add action, add a tag, and then here I say event requested checklist X, for example. So then we have add, so then that happens. So then we click integrate, then we click save and exit. Then you obviously have to put it on your website, but then when someone fills out that form, they get that tag. And then based on that tag, we can start an automation. So that's the lead magnet delivery. So this is an actual automation that I'm using to deliver like checklists or freebies, or if you, for example, get the email tagging framework, then you also go through an automation like this. Now, to start an automation, you can add a trigger. Now you see here that I already added the trigger to like start the automation when the tag is added. So in this case, it is tag event requested checklist is added, then the automation will start. So to do that, you just click add new trigger, and then you click tag is added. Now, and then the first thing that I do is that I remove this tag, because that tag has served its purpose. It's not relevant for me to know later on that they requested this checklist. Now, then I send them an email to send the checklist. Then I wait until they open this email. Then if they didn't do that, or if they do that, they will continue after 2 days. And then I'm going to check, did they open it or not? Now, if they did not open it, then I'm sending an email again with a different subject. And then I'm also waiting until someone opened this email or this email. Now, and if they do that, then they're going to get a tag that says event received checklist. So this is just my personal preference where I do this. You can do this different, but I just really like to use the requested tags when someone is requesting a thing. And then as soon as I know, like, okay, they opened the email, they actually downloaded the checklist, then I give them a tag that says event received checklist X. Now, then I'm going to show you some conditional content. It's actually inside this email. But first, I have to show you how a certain automation works. So this automation is tagging new subscribers for a few minutes. So someone subscribes to any list, then we give them a tag that says event, recent activity, joined list. Then we wait for 15 minutes and then we delete that tag. Now, what's that handy for? I will show you that right now. So we have this email, and in this email, we deliver the lead magnet, so we deliver the checklist in this example, but we also want to give them like a little welcome to the list, right? Like they downloaded something for the first time, super cool. So we want to say something like, hey, thanks for joining the list. I'm glad you found me in this little corner of the internet. From now on, I will send you one valuable email every Tuesday. Now, blah, 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 blah. And then we say, here is a checklist you asked for. Now, this part inside this box will only be sent to people who have the tag event recent activity joined list. And you can set it up here. So I created this like in like a little box. So to do that, you have to like drag like a new text element in there, and then you can do that. And then you have to click this little wheel, and then you click manage conditions. And then you see that this is a conditional content block, and this will only be shown to people where they have the tag equals event recent activity joined list. So this is like a little example, but you can use conditional content for so many different things. So yeah, that's that. And then I want to show you how you can actually split an automation based on a tag. So let's go back over here to automations. And then I'm going to show you a little example with webinars. So here is a simple follow-up. So imagine someone signs up for your webinar, and then after the webinar, you want to send different emails depending on if someone attended the webinar, did not attend the webinar, or left the webinar early. So how these tags are added to ActiveCampaign, that really depends on your webinar software. But if you use like a smart tool like EverWebinar, or I'm for example using Demio, then that's really, really easy. Then you can automatically do that. So when someone registers to a webinar, then you can see that here, they get a tag, something like this, right? Webinar registered webinar X. Now then, what you want to do after they attended or not attended or left early, we add these tags and then we start this automation. And then we want to split the automation based on which tags a contact has. So here you see that with an if else, you can add those like this, conditions and workflow, if else, and then you see them here. So here we check if a contact has this tag. Does it have this tag, like webinar attended and then the webinar name? If yes, they will follow the yes path, and then this person will get an email that says, thanks for attending. If not, then we're going to check, okay, did this person not attend at all? So we check if this person has the tag webinar did not attend and then the webinar name. Now, if yes, then we send an email that says like, hey, I missed you, click this link to join again, or maybe a replay or whatever. But that's how that works. And then if the person did not attend, but also did, like if the person did attend wow, that's really confusing. So if the person did like either not attend or not attend, I'm not sure how to say that, but you guys hopefully get it. Then we check, okay, did this person leave the webinar early? If yes, we ask them like, hey, notice that you couldn't see the whole thing. Would you like to see a replay? Now, and if that's also not true, then we just end the automation. So it's just like a super simple webinar follow-up. Like for example, you could also extend it by if someone did not attend the webinar, that you keep sending them reminders to maybe watch the replay or attend again or whatever it is. But just to show you how you can split automations with an if else based on certain tags. So yeah, I hope that this helped you to understand how they work. So I want to give you some like best practices to like close this tutorial off. So give all your tags like really clear names. Like later on, you will thank yourself, because otherwise it's going to be a huge mess, and then you just do not know how, yeah, what's happening, what's going on. So what I really want you to do is to create your own tagging framework. So definitely import the example that I created and change to your own needs. Then only use tags if you need them for something. So do not create unnecessary tags just in case, right? So only create tags for things that you need. And as soon as a tag has served its purpose, then just delete the tag. So that was this tutorial. If you enjoyed it, give it a little thumbs up. It would help me a lot. And also, if you want to see more tutorials like this, then be sure to subscribe to the channel. And if you have any questions, then you can just let me know in the comments below.